Hi everyone, it's John.
And Ben.
And we have something big and something pony related in this mystery box right here.
That is a very big box.
We saw this at the My Little Pony Fair in Chicago at the Hasbro booth.
Yes,
didn't think it was going to be out so soon, but it showed up on Amazon a couple days later and checked this out.
OMG!
This is the Cutie Mark Magic Canterlot Castle, and this is huge.
So excited.
If you thought the Twilight Sparkle Castle from last year was big,
wait until you see this thing all put together.
It has a working elevator. It has figures of Spike standing up. That's the same one that came with the celebration cars. Mm-hmm. Comes with Princess Celestia and over 40 plus accessories.
Wow. This is going to take me all day.
And when all assembled, it says it'll be 29 inches. Or 74 centimeters tall. So this thing is going to be pretty massive.
The catacombs, wasn't that 36 inches? Yeah, which is over here. I think this is 36 inches, so if that gives you an idea how tall this thing is gonna be.
Here's what the back of the box looks like.
Isn't that cool? You can ride up and down the elevator.
Here are the instructions in 11 steps.
That can't be all 11 steps. Oh my goodness, it is. These are not going to be very detailed instructions, I don't think.
Here's some parts, and there's Spike and Celestia.
It does look like she has a little smudge. Look how cute Spike is.
Okay, Ben, can I get some parts? There's some parts. Let's see what's in this big part. There's some more in here.
See how he's emptying this on the floor? You know what he's gonna do? He's gonna get up and say, have fun! Let me know when it's done! And walk away.
I'm not gonna do that. Look at all these parts. And some of these are attached to cardboard.
Actually doesn't look too bad.
Well, let's see how long it takes you to put it together, Ben. Well, have fun, Ben. And here is the Canterlot Castle, all assembled.
I got it together.
How was it to put together this time?
It wasn't too bad. Believe it or not, there weren't really that many pieces. The instructions were not really that great, though.
How so?
Well...
This is important information. If you're a parent who may be putting this together on Christmas morning or at a birthday party, you may want to take note of the time on this video because Ben is going to give you some important information.
Okay, so first off, step one. This one, it appears that when you're putting the first floor together down there, that you're putting, see how the scenes look like they're an outside, like shrubbery and outside of a window? Actually, you want to flip those so that the interior of the castle is showing through here, not the exterior of the castle. They have this on backwards. This whole wall doesn't fit facing the direction they have it showing.
So there is a misprint on the instructions.
Yes. So either these stairs should be flipped so that you're looking at the back of them, or this wall should be flipped. That's important to know. Or you're going to have the windows on the inside and the outside bathroom on the outside of the castle. It doesn't really work. This one, it does show you this section right here is this. We're going to go over it, but it's a comb, you know, so that the kids can wear it as like a tiara. But you can very easily miss the step of connecting the comb to the tiara part so that it makes it very hard to put in here when you don't have the comb on it. It's on the instructions right there, but it's very easy to miss it when you're following along with all the railings and you just get to the top and you're like, wait, how's that supposed to connect on there? Well, you follow that little circle and it'll tell you. I think those are the major ones, but the cardboards, they don't go in very easy. I
guess like Twilight's playset, the backdrops are all cardboard.
Yes.
This is definitely the biggest MLP playset they've done to date, and you can see it towers over
Twilight's
and the Royal Wedding Castle. Poor Shiny and Cadence have the tiniest castle.
Yeah. I feel bad for them because their castle's so tiny. On the show, though, it's massive.
Speaking of the show, I was pretty impressed how show accurate this castle looks. You know, at least, you know, for like the skyline up here.
All the, like, that one, that one, that one, that one, and behind the tiara, all those things, they're like a hard, they're like a rubber, so they are flexible, but they're kind of a pain to put on. You could get them on, but they don't like snap or anything. You just push them on really tight and then they stay, but they're not that fun.
So this is another note to parents who have the job of putting this together. Ben, how long did it take you to put this together? She doesn't let me touch it, so she does it all solo.
Yeah, he gets in my way. I don't know. How long did it take? An hour?
It must have been an hour.
We periscoped some of it. yeah, probably an hour, maybe. But I did have to redo the bottom floor because I had the windows going the wrong way.
Here's a quick rundown of the castle. Now, all over this castle are these little codes that you can scan into the app.
Oh, yeah. So they have those little codes everywhere. There's one in the bakery, one in, like, her bedroom. And there's also one down, that's kind of behind the pillar, but there's one on the notebook down there on the easel. And there is one on Celestia.
Now, what you're supposed to do with these little codes, like the little ones on the Equestria Girls, you can zap them into your phone when you download the MLP app.
Yeah. So you can, you know, interact your real-life play with interactive play. So
that's pretty cool. So let's start at the bottom floor. We're just going to do a quick rundown of the place before we hand things over to our Ponyville friends. There's this nice staircase. Now down at the bottom, what is that? It looks like a bathroom?
Yeah, I think this is a bathroom. There is a sink with a mirror, and you can actually flip that around so that you don't have the mirror showing if you don't want to. She also comes with like a little bath rug. There are some hand towels. This chest I put, this probably looks familiar to you guys, but I put all of the hair accessories in there.
A lot of these accessories will look familiar. They've recycled a lot from previous play sets.
I do like these
candelabras.
Yeah, they're pretty cool. Actually, you have to assemble some of them because they come separated like that, and you have to put the lights on them.
They don't actually light up, though.
No, they don't light up, but I just think they look cool.
Over here is Twilight's favorite room.
It's like the library.
You can see a couple scrolls down there, like when she writes a letter to Twilight, or vice versa.
There's two of them, and they have the little section so you can hook it onto their hook.
And speaking of our Celestia, I don't know if we mentioned it earlier, but in the package, she has like a little scuff on her nose.
Yeah, she's been playing in the dirt.
But she has very sparkly wings and she has the glitter in her mane.
Yeah.
This is a really nice Celestia. Hopefully, I mean, we're going to have to use like a magic eraser or something so we can get that smudge off her nose.
There's also some paint over here.
There was also like some glue or some sort of residue on her face. You can see it there reflecting in the light. So a couple imperfections, but it is a nice Celestia figure.
Yeah.
And it also comes with
a little handsome Spike with a bow tie.
Standing up. This is, as we said earlier, that's the same little Spike that came with the celebration cars from a couple of years ago.
But a lot of people weren't able to get a Spike like this, so it's nice that he's back in the action.
Over here we have the kitchen/bakery. Mm-hmm. There's a picture of Twilight on the wall in that room for some reason.
Yeah, she's right there. Apparently
Teacher's pet.
Yeah.
Teacher's pet.
Uh-huh. Teacher's pet, all right.
And we have all sorts of goodies that will make Pinkie Pie very happy, including a little serving tray.
This thing is really cool.
I'm thinking we've seen that before as well, maybe with the wedding castle. I don't know.
Probably.
I don't remember. I think we've had one of these before.
They have so many food accessories that I actually had to put some on the bottom of this tray so I had somewhere to put the food. And it's all along this table where I put the cake.
As you can tell, because you can see our logo peeking out from behind, but those are like very thin, translucent pieces of plastic for the stained glass windows, and it's a really, really cool touch.
Actually, one of them is yellow, and one of them is like a bluish color. I don't know if you can tell because our logo is behind it. They are different colors to have Celestia and Luna present in the castle.
There's also a chandelier hanging from the ceiling. I thought it was the same as the one that came in Twilight's castle, but looking at them side by side, that one is a little different.
Yeah.
Over here, we have, by a roaring fire, it looks like Celestia's bedroom.
Yeah, well, I made it that way. I don't know if it's supposed to, but she comes with this bed-type thing.
It looks like a bed.
Yeah, I think it's supposed to be a bed.
It looks like a dog bed.
It does. I'm treating it as her bed because it's pretty big.
Mm-hmm.
And I put a little end table there.
And we've already looked at the top, and it looks like she comes with, like, this little scepter.
Yeah.
I don't know how she can hold that. She probably just levitates it, right?
Yeah, probably. I don't even know. I don't know what it's for. There's nowhere to put it.
And the play feature here, which is awesome. You see her throne right here? Okay, Ben, demonstrate what Celestia can do.
So it's on the ground. There is this peg right here that you can put the whole of her hoof on. So you stick her in there. And there she is on her throne. And then, I'm going to move Spike out of the way. Go there. You twist this little flower on the front of it. And she goes up.
Going up.
Going up. And voila, she's at the top. And she can stop anywhere along the track of the elevator. Oh no, the elevator's stuck!
I really, really like this playset. Oh, we should flip it around too to show what's on the back.
Oh yeah, you have to see the backside. We get so excited with these that we forget some crucial details here.
And there's tons of room in there, plenty of room to display all sorts of ponies.
So you can kind of see the color of the glass better from the back.
Here is what the back looks like.
This is part of the elevator. It doesn't actually do anything. It's just, it's how it's attached to the playset.
And I see a couple more of those. I think they're called zap codes now that I think of it.
Oh, yeah. There's one
on there and one in that little orb down there on the bottom.
Yeah. I also want to point out that you can actually take these off if you want to.
For more room for play down at the bottom.
But see how there's like... There's that. So maybe you can attach it to, like, over here if you wanted, or if you wanted to move it out of the way, you could snap it onto the side. I'm guessing. I don't know if that's an actual feature, but it seems to work. So you could snap them here. And then the stairs are out of your way. Then you can slide. Oh, that's neat! Look at that!
Oh, wow. I didn't know you could do that.
I didn't either. I just figured it out right this very moment. Then you can slide them all the way along the side. I like that.
If you do get this, be aware that there is assembly required, a lot of assembly required, and to follow those instructions, or else these playsets they kind of fall apart. Because we occasionally get complaints from parents like, how do you get this thing to stay together? And it's like, I don't know. Especially the Twilight set from last year, we haven't had any issues with it, but we've heard lots and lots of complaints about how the slide falls apart. You know, they have to put it together with super glue.
And the only issue with ours that I've noticed is this comes off really easy. I don't know what we do that makes them stay together, but...
We follow the instructions. I guess that's our best advice.
We know they can be a little tricky to follow, though.
So this is... It's huge. It's amazing. If you have a lot of room to display your ponies, we paid $90 for it on Amazon. I was like, that seemed a little high, but once we got it, the box is humongous.
Mm-hmm.
And seeing them side by side, you can see how it towers above the other two.
Yeah.
But a really, really nice display piece, and it's going to be cool to fill that with ponies.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Woohoo! I guess that would be one little... thing they could have improved on. There could have been a little peg on those stairs. Or
Spike.
Yeah, so Spike could stand on it. So if you like this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel.
And like and comment.
Hey, wait a minute, guys. I usually take part in these playset videos. And we almost forget about Shining Armor.
Yeah, well, how could we do that?
Well, we went on so long talking about the Shining Armor, we were thinking of doing a special skit with you in Canterlot Castle coming up tomorrow. How's that? That sounds great.
Well, I guess that was easy. I thought he was going to argue with you. Wow.
He's very agreeable.
He is.
It makes me worried for Canterlot Castle, though. What could Shining Armor do?
A lot, probably.
So you want to stay tuned for that? And don't forget to follow us on Instagram.
On Facebook.
And Twitter. We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.